Today we are going to talk about the functions window. When you open a file in IDA, you will immediately notice several tabs below the navigation band. These are the different IDA views. Functions, IDA view, also known as the disassembly view, hex view, structures, enums, imports, exports, graph overview, and output. The functions window is one of the important views, and it is open by default. The purpose of this window is to list all the functions in the database recognized by IDA. Initially, the window shows just the function name and a part of the segment columns, but you will see that there are some more columns. If for some reason the window is not displayed, you can show it by going to View, Open Subviews, and select Functions. Alternatively, you can use the Shift and F3 shortcuts. Next to Segment, it shows the Start column. That's the absolute address of the function. Then we have the function length in bytes, followed by locals. That's the size of local variables, including saved registers. Arguments shows the size of arguments passed to the function. Then we have R. It indicates that the function returns to the caller. F stands for far function, while L is for library function. M is for Lumina function. O shows outlined code. S is a static function. B indicates whether the function uses a frame pointer, BP. IDA automatically converts operands to stack variables. And T indicates that the selected function has a prototype. The last column, the equal sign, indicates that the frame pointer points at the bottom of the stack frame. If you want to hide some of the columns, right-click with the mouse somewhere on the list and select Columns. Click on the ones you want to hide or show and confirm your selection. There is one more way to do that. Click on a cell within the column you want to hide, right-click with the mouse and select Hide Column. To show it back, you need to go back to Columns and make the relevant checkbox active. You will notice that your functions listing has different colors, and some functions are in bold. In most cases, the colors match the legend in the navigation bar. If you watched our previous video, you should already know the meaning of these colors, but if you haven't, we are going to cover some of them again. Cyan is for library function, for example, a function recognized by a flirt signature as a compiler runtime library function. Magenta shows an external function thunk, for example, a function implemented in an external module, often a DLL or a shared object. Lime green indicates a function with metadata retrieved from the Lumina database. Some more colors could be displayed in the listing. Light green shows a function marked as decompiled. If you spot any other color, this is probably because someone else manually set it via edit function or assign it in a plugin or script. The functions marked in bold have a defined prototype, for example, types of arguments, return value, and calling convention. The prototype might be defined by the user, yhotkey, or set by the loader or a plugin, for example, from the dwarf or PDB debug information. It is important to know that double-clicking on a function from the list will jump to the last address-aware view. You might also notice that the yellow arrow in the navbar will also move to reflect the correct position within the bar. The other way around is possible only if you synchronize the functions window with the disassembly IDA view. To do that, right-click anywhere in the functions window and select Turn on Synchronization. Once synchronized, the functions listing will reflect your position in the disassembly. To switch it off, right-click again and select Turn off Synchronization. As the functions listing sometimes is long, you would want to look at the ones that interest you most. Sorting is one of the features you could use. Just click on a column header and your selection sorts the whole list. For example, you might want to sort the list by function size, from the largest to the smallest. When sorting, you will notice some messages showing in the output window. We recommend you to reset sorting and filtering once you found what you are looking for, since otherwise it may slow down IDA. To do that, right-click anywhere in the functions window and select Unsort. Filters are a great way to show, hide, or highlight functions by given criteria. Let's first see the quick filter. To access it, right-click on the window and select quick filter. Another way is to use the Ctrl F shortcut. You can then start typing to narrow down and highlight your results. The Modify Filters is a bit more comprehensive option. Right-click again and select Modify Filters. Or use Ctrl-Shift-F shortcut. The fields are pretty straightforward, and we won't cover them now. Performing a search is also possible. Just write Alt-T shortcut to open the dialog, write the string you want to search for, and IDA will jump to the result. If there isn't a match, a message will be displayed in the output window. If there is more than one result, you can use another shortcut, Ctrl-T, to jump to the next one in the listing. Another helpful option to consider is organizing functions in folders. To do that, right-click and select Show Folders. You will see that a wide vertical section shows up in front of the function name. To make a folder, select a function or multiple functions, right-click and choose Create a folder with items. Pick a name and confirm. You should now see your folder on the top, holding your functions. To add more functions to the folder, just use drag and drop. For taking out a function or several functions, simply select them and drag them out of the folder. If you want to remove the folder, empty it and use the Delete key. To hide folders, deactivate Show Folders from the context menu. As we've mentioned, you can select multiple functions and perform some more operations on them. Delete, add a breakpoint and Lumina push-pull only for the selection. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Show us how we did it below, and don't forget to keep following our channel for more helpful content.